Perfect. So what we want to do here today is really just have a conversation with all of you. Will had reached out to me, of course. You know, we've been working here trying to make sure that we're giving as many resources as we can to our customers. And we know that this is a really tricky, uncertain time. I mean, we feel that too. So Will, why don't you first start just by sharing with everyone what your hope is in having this conversation today?
Thanks, Nina. Thanks for organizing it. You know, in the good times, being small business owners, we all feel alone, right? Feel like we're on an island and that not all of us have all the support that we'd like to have or the people to share with or to talk about. And that's especially true during times like this. When it's trying times, it's always nice to hear from others and maybe get ideas and experience share on ways to navigate it. And if you can walk away from today's, you know, 15, 20 minutes with one or two nuggets that will help you navigate this trying time. And, you know, as I always look at it is that, you know, the sun will come out and shine again, right? No matter how tough the road seems or how the odds seem against us, the sun always comes out and shines again. And it will for this too. But so let's talk about some things that we can do that can be proactive and that will hopefully give you some things to think about and help you get through this trying time.
Totally, thank you. And so for those of you that are joining that might not know Lil, let me just give a brief intro and then we'll dive right into the meat of what we're gonna talk about. So Lil is a serial entrepreneur. She has really an impressive background of building a lot of businesses. And with that, with all that success, does come struggle. So Lil's been through the dot-com bust. She's been business or taken businesses through, you know, the challenging times of 9/11, 2008, you know, hurricanes, and now this. So Lil has a lot to share with all of you. And we also have a lot to share just from what we've heard from our customers. We help hundreds of customers all over the country. We've heard a ton from them over the last, you know, few weeks. And we want to share that with everyone.
Absolutely.
So let's jump into the conversation. I'm going to turn our video off momentarily just so we can share some snippets with all of you guys. So Lil, let's talk about what we've really learned, really what you have learned from the past. So, you know, you've been through that. You've been through times like this before. What have you found to really be successful? What are practices that you've done to really help yourself and your business come out of this?
Well, thanks. Thank you, Nina. You know, at the core of it, it's about controlling the things that you can control, right? And, you know, of all the business challenges that I'm sure lots of you have been through with 9/11 and the dot-com and the 2008 recession, this one seems to be the hardest that we're facing that we've ever seen in our lifetime, right? And so it's global. It affects everybody we know, so there's really no reprieve from anywhere you turn that your heart just doesn't hurt. And you think, how are we going to get through this as a business? How are we going to get through this for our teams? And so what I like to do is I think that you have to move the noise away and try to focus on the areas that you can absolutely control. And part of that is, you know, every couple of days going through this exercise of, what does it look like if this lasts 1 month? What does it look like if this lasts 3 months? And what does it look like if it lasts 6 months? And with doing that, don't commit yourself to any one of those scenarios because somewhere in between is what it's going to be, right? So if we dive into what are the things that you can control? The things that you can control are some of your expenses, you know, you've probably heard and are seeing where people are asking for help from their landlords, whether it's a, you know, rent abatement or extra time. You can do that with a lot of your vendors where you can, if you have a loan, you can ask the bank to put that payment to the back and just extend it. So you want to try to hang on to the cash flow where you can. You don't necessarily want to go through your business and slash everything thinking, okay, we're just never going to have it because that's going to interrupt service. Both to you and also to those companies that you want to survive when this all settles down, right? Because at some point this will settle down. You know, the irony of it is that Apple is open in China and closed everywhere else, right? And so how fast that turned And when I say how fast, you may think, oh, well, it's not that fast. It's 2.5, 3 months. But it is fast because they're back, and now they're going to go back to business. And so we have to figure out, how do we get through this? And, you know, I'm a firm believer that with some of the news that we're seeing, where Japan has a couple of vaccinations that they're getting early traction with, and you know, and also a prescription that's getting early traction, that we may not have to go through 3 months of it. But, you know, I, like all of you as business owners, we're all very optimistic, right? And that's what, you know, we always see the glass overflowing, but that very well could happen for us. So look at your fixed expenses, look at your, where you can adjust, where you could get some relief, where you could keep cash in the bank. Then same thing goes with your team. This is an opportunity where you can look at your team and you can say, you know, are there areas that you can change in the business? Are there things where maybe some of your team members that are full-time would be willing to go part-time? You know, how can you navigate? And don't think in your head, no, they won't. Have the conversation with them. This is the time to communicate with your team. They're just as, you know, they have just as much anxiety, if not more, than we all do as business owners. And the future is uncertain for all of us, but we do know the sun will shine again, right? So,
absolutely. No, that's a good point, Lil. And we're actually getting some comments from some of our attendees. So I'm going to turn our video back on. They want to see us. So here we go. Guys, we're here. We are still here. So no worries. And thanks for the feedback. I think your points that you just brought up, those are all so helpful for business owners. I want to kind of move into some questions that we've heard specifically. So customers of ours that have asked us these questions and are seeking some sort of, you know, advice and direction. And you hit on some of these things, but one of the questions that we've heard quite a few times is, you know, before all this happened, I had a lot going on in my business. What should move forward? What should wait? You kind of just hit on some of these things, move forward with, you know, prioritizing. And what's your feedback for business owners about that?
You know, great question. Two things. I can share what we're doing. So what we're doing is that we're looking at how do we better prepare that we're further ahead when we come out of this. So for all of us, our phones may be ringing less, right? Maybe not us as much because we're in tax. And so small business owners need their financials and they're also looking to get loans. And so we're a little bit busier in that area. But do you have a technology project that would help you to reduce costs in your business and that have your team more productive that you've been putting off because you just haven't had the bandwidth to get it done? And it may be very scary to move forward with that because you're thinking, oh, it's gonna have a monthly recurring revenue piece or expense, but talk to those manufacturers and to the software providers because they may be willing to give you some type of a reprieve on that where they'll extend it out over a longer period of time. And this is the time to knock those projects out. Any kind of cross-training within your team, of course, provided that you're you know, being social distanced, right? So if you have training that you have to be one-on-one, you know, for us, we do training through our Ring Central where we can hold a Zoom meeting. So they use Zoom and we can still have our trainings where everybody can move forward with learning. So take care of some of those things in your business. And also for just overall knowledge, and maybe this is the time to think about, are there extra revenue areas that you didn't want to do before that now you're willing to do? You know, I can speak to our business in that prior to this situation, we typically wouldn't do a one-off tax return or a one-off catch-up bookkeeping. We were looking to build customers. We have customers in all 50 states and multiple countries. And we were looking to build customers that are long-term. But you know, we all have to do our part. And so we're doing the one-off tax returns because we know business owners need a one-off tax return to get caught up so they can get a loan to survive. And at the end of the day, we all help each other. You know, rising tides raise all boats, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And your comment about us kind of extending and offering tax returns as a one-off, which we haven't typically done before, leads me into the next question that we've gotten from some business owners. Small business loans. There's a lot that's been announced, you know, over the last week or so, probably will continue to be, of how there's going to be additional resources and things for businesses to take advantage of. Most or possible that some of our small businesses haven't applied for a small business loan before. So where do you think they should start? I mean, obviously we want to make sure they have resources that they need, their financials in order. Any tips or recommendations for them on that?
Yeah, 100%, 100%. So absolutely go out and get the $50,000 loan that the government is offering that is interest-free in 1 year. You absolutely need to apply for that. When we send out the webinar link, we'll put out links to those resources. So, you know, I can tell you that also the state of Florida is doing a disaster loan. So if you happen to be in the state of Florida, like we are, there's a $100,000 loan that's available. For us, these loans aren't available because we're an investor-backed company. But for small business owners that are, one or two partners, as long as one of the partners own 51% or more of the company, then you can apply for the $50,000 government loan. Apply soon, quickly, first in, first out. You know, you can have the money in 30 days and it could be that bridge that you need. So I highly recommend jump on that loan.
Great. And I'll just mention quickly, if anyone that is attending right now, if you guys have a question, please enter that. We have a Q&A box right in the screen that you can just enter that and we'll answer. One of the next ones that we've heard, and a lot, again, is also coming out every single day about this, the tax deadline, the tax payment deadline. So we know that's been extended. Just any comments on that or anything you want our business owners to know?
Definitely. So there's a lot of confusion in that. Your tax return filing has not been extended. You still must file your personal return by April 15th. If you were a business, you must file that by March 15th. What's been extended is that if you owe money, the government is saying if you owe $1 million or less, you have until July, interest-free, penalty-free. And if you're a big business, you have up to $10 million, same thing to July. Now, we are hoping, depending on what happens in the next few days, next week, we're hoping they don't, because it means that they have a vaccination or something that's coming our way. But if those things don't happen, then we would imagine at some point they may extend that. But right now that hasn't been extended, they want you to go ahead and file. And of course, you know, you bring up a good point. We see over and over and over that business owners are so busy that they can't get to their tax returns and they actually have refunds coming and there's money sitting on the table that they haven't gotten to. So assess that. The other thing to assess is right now money is so cheap for loans on your business. If you have existing loans on your business, you should absolutely be calling your banker and trying to negotiate that loan payment down. Sometimes when you go ahead and you do that, you get a refi on that, you'll get a 45-day reprieve on a payment. And these are also things for you to be thinking about for your homes as well. If you're paying 5-6% on your house, you know, bring that payment down. It's going to help your cash flow. You know, what I can share is we all will get through this. Some of us may have different businesses that come out of this or may have a period of time that their business is not open, especially if you're in events or travel or businesses related to that, but it will come back. We've seen it come back every single time. You know, pat yourselves on the back for you know, going through this, and it will make you stronger, it will make you sharper, and it's okay to have the days that you feel really down and you just want to, you know, stay under the covers in the morning when you get up. I'm sure we all have those moments right now, right?
Yeah, and that's a nice segue. We did get a question from someone attending, and I think this is, and you bring up a really good point. Sometimes we forget business owners are people too, right? So they have personal emotions and feelings, and you know, we want to keep things light, obviously, but we also, it's a scary time. So you yourself, business owner, you have all this experience owning businesses. How are you, what advice can you give to somebody else with keeping your personal spirits up, even amidst kind of this, what could be looked at as a very gloomy time? What advice do you give other business owners on tempering that?
Nurture yourself. You know, as business owners, we have to be rocks for our business, for our team members, for our customers. But, you know, nurture yourself. So what do I mean by that? If taking a bath at night makes you feel good, do that. If listening to some music, whatever it is that makes you feel good, try to do that every day. and you know, believe in that we will come through this. We have always come through this, and this is the worst we've ever seen in our lifetime. But the Spanish flu of, you know, 1918 was really, really bad. The Depression was really, really bad. You know, we all get through it, right? We get through it. So stay positive, be good to yourself, let yourself feel down if you need to feel down. But as business owners, it's really important for us all to be there for our teams, and be truthful with your team. You know, if you need to cut the team, cut the team. Don't keep them in limbo. Be honest with them. Be loving, and be human.
Great advice. I think that's super super personal, obviously coming straight from your heart. And I think everyone here can really take that. And the last thing that I'll just say, and then I'll give you final words, is that we have a lot of resources that we've been putting together. Some of them are already up and live, and others will be coming in the next, or today and tomorrow. So definitely, if there's anyone that's listening, or even if you think there are other business owners that can benefit from hearing some of the message that Lil has to say, you know, share this with them. We'll share the recording out. We have a resource that we're putting up on our site, which is just a consultation, just a talk to you, help you kind of work out some of the questions that you might be asking yourself. We're certainly here for that, and more than happy to be a sounding board for you. Any other comments from you, Lil?
Well, thank you, Nina. Thank you very much for putting this together. And a thank you to all of you who are taking the time to attend. You know, you're doing a great thing for your business because you're reaching out and you're getting tips and you're looking for ways to get through the business. What I would say is, you know, we as business owners, a lot of our friends are business owners. So reach out to your friends, see how they're doing, and help them to, you know, they may have a good day and you're having a bad day and they're going to lift you up, and it may be vice versa. And so, you know, it's good for us all as individual human beings to lift each other up and stay focused. Control what you can control, and navigate through. We're happy to chat with you. I have an amazing team here of people that are extremely knowledgeable, and we're happy to help you in any way that we can to help you apply for loans, to understand the financial documents you may need, and of course to navigate through. And we look forward to seeing you on the other side, right?
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, thank you, Lil, for your time. And thanks, everyone, for taking a few minutes to join us. We hope this was helpful and informative, and we will be sharing out the recording. Have a great one, and we'll talk with you all soon.
Stay safe.